researches focused on transition periods was conditioned by the idea of progress that was associated with the concept of immigration. Although this model began to decay in the 20th century because of the impact of the world wars and the climate change, it is still applied to the study of past cities which move between ideas as decline or splendor. One of the most historical periods affected by this methodology is the one between the 6th to the 7th centuries, which began with the fall of the Western Roman Empire and the creation of new political realities known as barbarian kingdoms. One of this new formation is the Visigothic kingdom of the Iberian Peninsula. Traditionally, the process of transition from the Roman to Visigothic economy has been interpreted in a negative way, because the archaeological record shows evidence of an impoverishment of the material culture. So, in the rural world, there is a change from a centralized Roman system, which has the villa at the center, to a disorganized settlement, like farms, village, or hilltops. Which are characterized for using poor materials such as wood. Therefore, some researchers have interpreted this transition in a negative way, because there is an increasing of illiteracy and poverty in the rural world, compared to the richness and the illiteracy of the Roman system. In this context, we understand the lack of technology studies in late antiquity, because it is thought that in this period there were no technological innovations. However, the recent discovery of slaves with numerical inscriptions that are localized in a restricted area of the Iberian Peninsula, as you can see on the map, and whose meaning is still to be deciphered, question the idea of regression. This will imply accepting that illiterate peasants developed during this period a number system of their own, in accordance with the new needs of territorial management. That is, there was an innovation. The first researchers who tried to give an explanation to these numerical slaves believed that they must have been produced by the elite, because they believed that the signs of the slaves were Roman numerals, and it is impossible that a person of the 6th century knows the Latin alphabet. In fact, if we observe the signs of the slaves, we understand the origin of this appreciation, because we have the presence of symbols such as a cross, a V, and a stripe that are very similar to the Roman ones. In this presentation, I will address the following questions. Are the signs engraved on the slave Roman numbers? Can illiterate people develop a numeral system? And can peasant population of the 6th to 7th century have accounting needs? Let's go with the first one. If we analyze carefully the signs engraved on the slaves, there are characteristics that make me have doubts about their identification as Roman numbers. First, only three of the seven numbers of the Roman system are representative of the slaves. But the rest, L, C, D, and M, are totally absent of the representation. In addition, if they were Roman numbers, should appear signs forming substration like that, or 9, for example. But this combination are totally missing. Moreover, the signs of the slave do not appear forming a positional system to lower to smaller. It's an alternative anyway. All this reason led me to wonder if the signs are Roman numbers or a different type of system. If we can assume that they are not Roman numbers, they could be created by peasants for accounting. This led us to answer the two questions previously raised. Can illiterate population develop a numeral system? And if this is possible, what needs would they have to develop an accounting system? Let's go with the first one. The idea of progress makes us to associate literacy with arithmetic. For example, it is believed that an illiterate person is unable to perform mathematical operations. However, many anthropological studies have demonstrated the ability to account for the illiterate population. For example, the anthropologist Thomas Rusin showed how an illiterate person from the region of Rajasthan, was able to develop operations involving fraction and division. That is why the ability to read and write and the ability to perform arithmetical operations are individualized skills that can be developed in an independent way. But to argue that a literary person who developed a number system of their own, it was not enough to allude to psychoanthropological studies. I needed to find similarities of the use of the same things, the strip, the V, and the cross, for accounting purpose in other peasant cultures. The first positive result was given through the analysis of the tablet stick. Yes. They are wooden sticks used at a universal level by rural population to record animals or tools, but also deaths, hours of birth, etc. In other words, it is a peasant accounting tool. But the most amazing thing about this tablet stick is that the most common marks are the stripe, the V, and the cross. That is the same thing that we have in the numerical slates. We found an example of the use of tablet stick by shepherds of the Swiss Alps and in Amersa too. Also relevant is the study of the numerical system used by Mandaya 5 in the Ural Mountains, whose reference is 8 in the 4th century. These people use an accounting system on wood with numbers very similar to the Roman ones. If you can see, this is the Mandaya, this is the Tuscan, this is the Roman system, and they are very similar. But this phenomenon is not only limited to Europe and Asia, but we also find parallels in America. The most paradigmatic case is the Zunis, chief of New Mexico, whose tradition is 2,000 years old. It is impossible for this tribe, which has been isolated, to have had any contact with Roman system. Nevertheless, they developed numbers very similar to the Roman ones, as you can see in the statistic. Indeed, they use the subtraction system. This is 10, 10, 1, and 5, so 24. Use the subtraction system that before we think that only appeared in the Roman system, but not. So the presence of the signs is not an exclusive characteristic of the Roman number system, but it is used by rural population of different chronological and geographical contexts. So we must consider one last question. Did peasants in the 6th to 7th centuries need to develop their own accounting system? We can define bookkeeping as a tool used by active subjects of the economic relation to keep a record and control of their properties, debts, or trade. Therefore, every person, independently to his power or status, whether he owns goods or participates as a proactive element in economic activities, should use an accounting to manage these operations. But throughout history, not all people who were integrated into the economic are active, and therefore do not need to make an accounting. This could occur with peasants before the fall of the Western Roman Empire, because they were integrated into the vicarious system. This was characterized by the centralized management of the lord of the villa that we called dominus, who managed what they must produce and how it should be produced, and therefore the accounting activity was developed by him or his administrators. But after the fall of the Roman Western Empire at the end of the 5th century AD, the centralized system gradually disappears, giving rise to a new management of peasants over the rural world. They turn into active subjects in the economic space in which they are integrated. Therefore, they began to develop accounting needs. My hypothesis is that this accounting, keeping in mind psychological characteristics of this population segment, will be expressed by rural numbers, which are the ones we see on the numerical slates. The presence of some numerical slates found in archaeological sites, close archaeological sites, can be considered as evidence of this peasant accounting. One example might be the numerical slates found at the archaeological site of Cabeza de Navasan Gil in Spain, next to a carbonized grain storage, which would suggest that the slate was counting the grain storage. But apart from registering grain, peasants could have other accounting needs. The slate of the archaeological site of La Legoriza in Spain too was found in a closed structure next to a mill, whose presence indicates that in this space serial transformation would be made. Maybe the numerical slate were registering this activity. Another example is the numerical slate in Montalcaide, which was localized in a basin with a storage ceramic very close to 4 priests' rate to the elaboration of wine. This reinforced the theory that the numerical slate were used for registered wine productions. The last example is a slate with numbers and animals engraving. So this is an animal, it's the arms, the head, and the body, and the paws. And this is two animals that are five. That could be a livestock accounting, that the person make a livestock accounting. Consequently, I have suggested that the sign of the slate might not be Roman numbers, but numbers that was developed by peasants. Opposite the idea of the inability of illiterate peasants to develop accounting system, I have suggested that accounting and literacy are processes that can be totally independent of one another. Therefore, illiterate people could create numerical system. Third, through the analysis of the archaeological context of some slates, I suggest that peasants of the 6th to 7th centuries had daily accounting needs that are shown by numerical slates. Therefore, these numerical slates, far from being an exclusive product of the elites, could be used by literary people for expressing their accounting needs. In this respect, we could confirm that the transition from the Roman to the Visigothic system was not totally negative, because the technological innovations such as numerical slates were created. But if we accept that belief, we could make the mistake of thinking that innovation means progress, and it's not. Transition cannot be described as negative or positive, but as adaptation to new historical circumstances. And the numerical slates are precisely the result of this process of change. And that's all. Thank you.